I want to unlock the deepest, darkest parts of myself, because that's where the barrier lies. At least I think I do. I want to be creatively vast, but that comes with a long list of disclaimers and waivers, and I've never even gone to the doctor's office alone, let alone the pits of my own mind. It's like walking into a cave and the walls are scribbled with my deepest, darkest memories, and although I do believe I'm light when I'm face to face with the sun, when I pull that frame down and reveal the hole in the wall created by my own insanity, it seems I burn out. But you and I both know a flame has no shadow. So I try to remind myself that if I can't see my own shadow, I must be light.
So you have to ask yourself, do you think human creativity matters? Well, most people don't spend a lot of time thinking about poetry, right? They have a life to live and they're not really that concerned with Allen Ginsberg's poems or anybody's poems. Until their father dies, they go to a funeral, you lose a child, somebody breaks your heart, they don't love you anymore. And all of a sudden, you're desperate for making sense out of this life. And has anybody ever felt this bad before? How did they come out of this cloud? Or the inverse, something great. You meet somebody and your heart explodes, you love them so much you can't even see straight. You know, you're dizzy. Did anybody feel like this before? What is happening to me? And that's when art's not a luxury, it's actually sustenance. We need it. Okay, well, what is it?
All right. When you put away your phone in time, you'll look at life and know that the posts and snaps from your closest chaps are only there for show. And while some scroll for far too long, they pollute and poison their minds. The truth is far too bleak for them, and they'd rather close the blinds. It's all about the angle, or the filter that you use. But with a pretty smile and a chosen style, they will hide where they may bruise. And you'll see girls and boys along the way, but to compare yourself is foolish. For we all have defects and have felt like rejects. But don't let it make you foolish. When you put away your phone in time, know that life is not a post. It shows the good, the bad, and the ugly. And it's real. Unlike most.
The spark within grows dim as routine's grip takes hold. Where once danced visions bold, now only shadows swim. Each day the same dull track, no time to dream or play. Bright colors fade to gray. Imagination locked in rack. The inner child now quiet, adventure but a memory. Wonder a luxury, curiosity a riot. Yet somewhere deep below, the embers still aglow. Breathe on them, let them grow. Creativity's river will flow.
Creative living is any life that you live where your decisions are based more strongly on your curiosity than your fear. And if you consistently, habitually, routinely, at every sort of intersection and decision in your life, make decisions that are based on curiosity rather than fear, then you will be engaging with creativity. Your life itself will sort of become a work of art.
Hello, my name is Eric, and this is a poem I wrote. It's called Would've, Could've, Should've. And it goes a little something like this. In the realm of would've, could've, should've lies a land of regrets I often rove. Lost in my thoughts of what might have been, I ponder on paths I have not taken. Unseen regrets and what ifs fill my mind as I ponder the choices I left behind. Oh, the adventures I would've embarked upon if only I would've been a little more bold and strong. The places I would have seen if only I had chased my wildest dreams. But dwelling on all the would-haves won't change a thing. Should I spread my wings and let my heart sing? For in this moment I have this power to reshape my future and make it flower. And could've, a realm of endless possibilities where dreams and aspirations find their ease. Could've soared high on wings of ambition, but life's twists and turns lead to a different mission. I could have taken paths less traveled, unknown, but fate's hand guided me down a path of my own. I could have danced with the stars in the moonlight's embrace. However, destiny's steps led me to a different space. I could have whispered secrets to the midnight breeze, yet silence prevailed, a hushed symphony of unease. I could have painted the world with vibrant hues. Nevertheless, shades of gray settled, my canvas subdued. I could have loved fiercely, my heart unbound. Still, life whispers, not this time around. I could have written stories that would inspire, yet my pages remained blank, a dormant fire. I could have embraced my inner outcast, the one on the fringe. Even so, fear of the judgment held me back, a self-imposed cringe. I could have stood tall, unyielding and strong, but doubt crept in, another whisper that was wrong. And don't get me started on the should-haves that linger in the depths of my soul, mumbling regrets like the mournful bell it tolls. Now screaming how I should have taken that chance, should have seized that day, how I should have followed my heart instead of letting them stray. How I should have said I love you when the moment was right. How I should have fought harder for what I believe in with all my might. How I should have pursued my dreams without fear or doubt. How I should have taken that leap and let my ambition sprout. The should-haves are ghosts, hunting my mind, changing me to their posts, taunting and teasing like a bitter, cruel jest, reminding me constantly of what I failed to manifest. Would've, could've, should've, they say. But taking refuge in the past won't pave my way. Instead, I'll learn from what's behind and reshape my future unconfined. What of the dreams I left untold? Could've the chances I didn't hold? Should've the choices I didn't make? For every would've that slipped away, there's a new opportunity in each day. Every could've leads to fresh possibility, and every should've can fill my ability. So I'm gonna embrace the lessons learned. From every twist and turn, life has churned. With courage and resilience, I'll find my way beyond the would've, could've, should've fray. For in the present, I have this power to reshape my life hour by hour. So I'll seize the moments and no longer wait to create my future that's bright and great. Thank you for listening.
I wrote a poem, it's called Small Giants. I'm gonna read it to you. Power over those closest, but beneath who made you. Stare into shattered reflections, don't see enough to break through. Big brother mentality, little brother reality. Leading by example, simultaneously following. Who's in charge? Towering over so much, mistaken for shade. Attention to the sky, neck stiff with thoughts to evade. They ask, how'd you get up there? Mentor or rival? Who deserves the space, master and pupil? Making changes, crushing dangers, pursue my greatness, you won't make it. Took so long, yet more time to spend, come so far. So far came with empty souls and no time to vent. Picket fence on my mind, reading for sale. Maybe the next will have better luck, trying to excel. The larger I grow, the tinier the reflection. Like a small giant gaining attention, but craving acceptance. Thank you.
A day is like a small life. You're born, you get up, you go to work for most of the day. Then when you get back home near the day's end, you're tired. But now this time is yours. You finally have the time to do what you've wanted, write, paint, or go for a run, but you're too exhausted. So instead you watch a film about someone else's life.
Most people
don't spend a lot of time thinking about poetry, right? They have a life to live, and they're not really that concerned with Allen Ginsberg's poems or anybody's poems until their father dies. They go to a funeral. You lose a child. Somebody breaks your heart. They don't love you anymore. And all of a sudden, you're desperate for making sense out of this life. And has anybody ever felt this bad before? How did they come out of this cloud? Or the inverse, something great. You meet somebody and your heart explodes. You love them so much you can't even see straight. You know, you're dizzy. Did anybody feel like this before? What is happening to me? And that's when art's not a luxury, it's actually sustenance.
This is a poem I wrote. In the creative garden, I forcefully inhale through my nose, smelling the sweet scent of rose. I walk between red sandalwood trees, her lamp guiding me. In the creative garden, ravens call from the treetops. An emerald-colored lynx exits the tree line, calling to me softly. It is beautiful. In the creative garden, the ravens descend on the lynx. A battle ensues. The lynx exits the chaos, its emerald coat shimmering reddish-green under the sun. Beauty runs away into the trees, triumphant. I rise.
You clearly want to make some, so why not just make it?
Because I'm scared.
Of what?
I don't know.
Exactly. You just answered your own question. Just make what you want to make. Worst come to worst, what's going to happen? You make it, someone says they don't like it. All right. Will you like it?
Yeah.
And that's all that matters.
According to scientists, loneliness shortens your lifespan. Something about the mental health effects. Something about the way your cells die every time a friend brushes your shoulder without saying hi or offering a smile 5 to 10 years, some studies said. Others gave percentages that felt meaningless. I didn't know how to equate them with the bottomless pit behind my chest. And can I just say, even though I know you're supposed to listen to the professionals, I don't believe them. The scientists are wrong. Loneliness is a killer, but it makes the hours feel painfully long. Loneliness stretches time, warps the clock, slows the second handle until the minutes finally stop. You recognize yourself. You notice everything you are. Your body is your sole company. There's no escaping. You are too far gone. Try talking to yourself and watch as you don't respond. Try being with yourself. And you'll find your mind isn't as tangible as you once thought. Let silence hug you from every angle. Let morning come, a sunrise winged angel. You must think I've got a bit of an ego, telling scientists they're incorrect, and maybe that's why I'm lonely. I'm to myself to be pleasant. They're brutal. The hours between conversations, and the less you have, the more time you're wasting. So the 5 to 10 years are not all that they seem. And if you want to live forever, simply never speak.
I needed to hear this morning, so maybe you do too. Just start. Without preparation, without delay, stop trying to be perfect. That's just getting in your way. No matter what you want to do, you already can. Why spend time setting up for things that don't need a plan? Ready is subjective. Your fears won't go away. So do the thing to move you closer to the person you want to be today. Then look back and see what worked, and you'll grow a little better every day. Every shot left untaken is a guaranteed miss, so shoot for the stars and see what hits.
I crave creativity. Whether these poems be fantasies or realities, whichever, I crave the ignition of my gift to be a driving force. A highway of ever sadness attempts to drive you insane. A smile of ever you're low on fuel, this is how I thrive. How I get lit without the alcohol, I am my own high. Tapped into a tune I love the most. Watching my pen dance on paper is enough entertainment, so yes, I am grateful for the gift of ink, for the gift of poetry. Touching you without touching you, I make you feel. For most days, this gift is untamed, like unleashing the beast in me. So goddess, to have vulnerability at the tip of my tongue, even if sometimes I am at the tip of a ledge, and the only thing falling are these tears, my pen. Has done more CPR, my body, waiting to exhale all the bullshit, my notebook, more confident, more safe. This pen pulls me more into the deep, so every day I will write with a warm tongue. For anyone in the midst of cold weather, for anyone looking for purpose, know that I write on purpose. Later, I love y'all.
As a creative, what you do has value. Hold up, just pause for a second. Let that thought break through. As a creative, what you do has value. Yes, it's true. It doesn't matter if you're a veteran or a rookie in the game. Your skill ain't the only thing to claim. Your art's value comes from your unique view. Your experiences that only you've been through. Yes, your skills assist, helps you articulate. But it's the soul within your art that captivates. Know that someone out there will adore your creations, eager to invest. So just break free from hesitation. How do you break free though? Share, lay your spirit bare. Your victories, your battles, the path you've tread, don't let them go unsaid. Embrace the process, the blocks, the highs, the lows. Use your social media as a stage, that's where your artistry grows. Strong branding, marketing tactics can hasten the rise. But first you must embark sharing your truth, watch time fly. So how will they find you if you're hiding behind closed doors? Remember, as a creative, your art has value. That's the core.